Welcome to It's Your Date with Destiny with Apostle Vivian and Pastor Gemma Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. For the next 30 minutes, join us as we take you on a journey of maximizing your potential and realizing your goals through Jesus Christ. Whether it's on a Sunday, Tuesday, or Friday, or any other day of the week, a warm welcome awaits you at Divine Destiny Worship Center, a place where your full potential is discovered. Here's a special invitation to join us at our sanctuary for today's...
The Lord says to somebody who is listening right now, do not be discouraged. For in the moment when you think it's all over, that's when God is ready to start to do what he has to do. I am prophesying into your spirit that it's not bad as your mind is making you think. If you really stand and take an honest inventory of yourself in relation to what's happening, you'll realize that God is really birthing something new. Birthing is never without pain. Birthing is always bloody and messy. But talk to the woman who has made a child, brought forth a child, and she'll tell you after the pain is over, that child emerges. And she looks at that child and says, God, I thank you. Sometimes, even if they don't believe in God, after all that pain, that child becomes a reason for praise. I don't know what God is doing with you, but I know at the end of the day, something is going to happen. At the end of this period, something's going to happen that's going to make you throw your hands up and say, God, I give you praise. Not the throwing your hands up saying, well, I'm done for. This time, lift your hands. Even before the thing happens, lift your hands and say, Lord, I thank you that you have even chosen me to go through such an intense test because you are bringing forth something fresh in my life that will bring me closer to my destiny, but that will also impact other people's lives. I want to anoint my hands right now and release an anointing for encouragement for the discouraged. Amen. Destiny Anointing Oil. This has been our point of contact for all the years we've been on television. And we are following a principle in the scripture written by Apostle James in the book of James. He says, if there's any sick among you, and sick here is generic of anything that's bothering you. If there's anyone sick among you, the thing that is making you sick is going to have to become subject to what? When the elders come, and I'm an elder, when the elders come and anoint you with oil, that thing will break. So we are following that principle. I'm going to anoint my hands with oil. Hallelujah. And I'm going to challenge you. Stretch your faith forth. Even if you don't stretch your hands forth, stretch your faith towards the source of anointing. Amen. Hallelujah. Last Sunday we read that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, to open blind eyes, to set captives free, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to open prison doors, and then to announce. It's a time of jubilee. I release it to you right now. Receive it right now. In the name of Jesus, be delivered. Be emancipated. Be liberated from that which has been holding you in bondage. Stretch your faith forth and say, Lord, I receive it. Say it again, Lord, I receive it in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. And if there's some sickness in your body or in the house where you live, I release the healing power, the healing virtues of Jesus to break that thing. Why not call and give us the testimony? Because I know somebody is getting released right now in the name of Jesus. Okay, so good morning. I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan. On behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters at Divine Destiny Worship Center, welcome you to this program. It's your date with destiny, a program that so many people wait for, wait on a weekend to receive a word from God. Somebody met me and said, wow, you don't preach like the other preachers. Well, I am me. I can't preach like anybody else. I just deliver it as the Lord gives it to us. Amen. And this is the first weekend in August. You know what we do every time we come to a junction like this? We challenge you with a question. What have you done with your Old Year's Night, New Year's Morning resolution? Have you started doing anything? Is there evidence that you are keeping the word you gave to God? I prophesy that you are a promise keeper and you will bring it to pass. The book, the business, the Bible class, the ministry. Come on, get it done in the name of Jesus. In fact, I rebuke that dropout spirit. You were just thinking about dropping out. I declare you shall take a deep breath and go back to the classes and get the job done. And that brings us into what we want to do this week again. We are extending the teaching on self-governance. And today, we want to give you a little peek into that dimension of it that is called principles and techniques of self-governance. Why not call up somebody and let that person be enlightened by what has been touching you over the last few weeks? Amen. Also call our number 633-3780 or any of the other numbers you are seeing there, and somebody is going to be willing to minister to you. While you are speaking to that person, tell the person, put a name down, put the telephone number down as well, because you would like to get the manual on the principles and practice of self-governance. You'll also like to get the video. So put your name down and somebody will contact you. Amen? Good. So God bless you as you view.
You never know. That's why you have to learn to govern yourself, especially this. Because of the four things that come not back, I think the word. Because you could still go and get the arrow. When you shoot it, pull it out of the target and bring it back and shoot again. The words that you speak, they're not coming back. So I want us to take in this with understanding and with a view to live it, not just hear it. Tell your neighbor, we're going to live it, not just hear it. Right, so the definition of self-governance. Here's where we're going to start tonight. Let's read. Self-governance is the proper management of one's self, or proper self-management. Management. Tell your neighbor, it's about doing it yourself. I really want to catch that because I cannot come inside of you to govern you. And you can't come inside of me to govern me. You cannot blame anybody for not governing yourself. What we are offering, what God and all is offering, is this: the principles, the pillars on which to build yourself, the foundation on which to rest yourself. But you have to do it. I have to do it. Are you hearing me? Today we had the memorial service for one of our covenanters who died in Texas, got buried in Texas, but her relatives who couldn't make it over there came and asked for us to hold a memorial service. And I did, in the message, I did the power of words. Words kill, words give life. The choice is yours. That's what it says in Proverbs. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. And those who love it will eat the fruit thereof. I think it's the Message Bible that says, words kill, words give life. The choice is yours. And I preach it. And towards the end, I'm praying for the offering. And then the Lord said, pray for people who need healing. And then the last part, he says, speak a word to backsliders who are here. I didn't know that backsliders here. But if God says so, say so. I say so. Two sisters came afterwards, crying. Apostle, you remember me? Isaiah. You know how long I haven't been in church? I say, yeah. I say, and you left church many times, and when you came back, you say, this is it. I say, well, let me pray for you. And another one, who was the sister of the one that died, got baptized here, but got sour on God. She too came, and they said, we're coming back to church. Amen. Hallelujah. I hope they would be here on Sunday. Why did I say that? It's the words that God had me speak that got into them and began a revolution. And they didn't care that all their friends had left. Two of them stood up right in front here. Pray for me. I want to come back to God. And one of them, and I know she's prophetic, she was here since in the old building. That's to tell you how long. She said, how come at the end of your prayer, you just suddenly say, and all prodigal sons come back? She said, you know, just last night, I said, Lord, when I go to that memorial, I'll go to Apostle Duncan and tell him, your prodigal daughter has returned. I said, very good. I said, don't play with God. He heard you. Words. You know, if you govern yourself and you govern what words come out of your mouth. You know, you could either make or break a person. You could speak a word in season that you don't even know is in season, but in that person's season, they needed to hear a word like that to come back to God. And listen to me, when you look back at a situation like that, the person now comes to the Lord. It was a situation that should have gotten you so mad vexed, but you chose to be at peace. And you're going to ask yourself, supposing I did use some Christian cuss, boy. Supposing, you know, that person would have been lost forever. Or at least be lost off your list that God has laid out for you. Do you know each of us has a list of people whom God expects us to impact to come to know him as Savior? What a tragedy it will be for your time in that person's space to be up and you did not challenge the person. Sometimes not even with the words of your mouth, but by the way you posture yourself. I never told a man that I'm a pastor. But he saw it. I wish we could understand that, because it is I that have to govern myself. It is I that have to manage myself. If you're thinking about answering the call from the Lord to travel all over the world, you know you have to learn to govern yourself. Pastor, pray for me. There's a traveling position from, you know, a job, and the boss say he want me to go. Yes. Have you established self-governance yet? And I'm talking about the simple things like how you manage your time. That's a self-governance demand. How do you manage your emotions? How do you manage your money? Because if your boss sends you out on a trip and they estimate how much you should spend and you run out of money out there, he ain't sending you back in. You should actually be able to come back with money. You're governing. Not everything is here. I want that. No, you have to watch things, want that, and leave that. Are you hearing me? Then you have people coming after you, people coming at you. I want to take you here. I want to. Hello. My time would not allow for it. self-governance is about one of the most important things in life after salvation. In fact, your salvation will be compromised. Your salvation could get, eliminated if you don't know how to govern yourself. Are you hearing me? But we learned something just now. Let's read. Self-governance is built on a truth that declares it is the state of well-being of the inner man and how well an individual has mastered the techniques of self-management that are the true drivers of the more abundant life, which is the quality of life that God intended for us to lead from the very beginning. Nothing missing, nothing broken, nothing lacking in our lives, but which we lost because of the fall. Genesis 1:28, we know what it says. In fact, 26 says, this is the plan. Let us make man. 27 says, God executed the plan. So God made man. 28 says, this is how God equipped the man that he made to live in the earth. What did he say? He says, and blessed them. That means he gave them the power. Because blessed here, as I've been saying to you, is not about car and house and all of that. Blessed here is about empowerment. Blessed is about what?
Empowerment.
And empowerment to do what? To prosper. And the word prosper, again, is not confined to money and houses and lands. Those are the fringe benefits of true prosperity. True prosperity is what? Is finding out, first of all, what is my destiny? And what is my purpose? Secondly, going to God and saying to God, yes, I accede to your demands on my life to bring forth the purpose and destiny. I receive your mandate. Thirdly, I say, God, you give me guidance as to how to fulfill this purpose that you have given to me. And in the process, like with Joseph, without even having to ask, God begins to put people in your life. Some are obnoxious as Mr. Potiphar. Some bad like Hitler. But if God put them there, they are to chisel you into a leader, into a person that will be a reflection, a representation, not just representative, but a representation of God. When they're looking for God, they look to you. Are we understanding that? The ambassador of Trinidad in London is Trinidad. Is that person is not a representative of Trinidad. That person is Trinidad. If Trinidad is to speak in England, that person speaks. Well, then the prophetic download is that I in the earth, I am heaven. If people are looking for heaven and what heaven entails, they must look at me. And in me, and that's why some people misinterpret this, but in Psalm 84, it says that we are God's, common G. In other words, we are microcosms or representations. All that God is supposed to be in us demonstrated. It's not that we are gods walking around like people must bow to us. Hello. No, it's not that. It means that we are the epitome. We are the exemplars to people of whom God would have been and what God would have done if he were here. Remember a few years ago, everybody walking around with a little band that says what? What would Jesus do? And that is true. What would Jesus do in the situation you know find yourself in? Think about that. So, if I'm to claim the more abundant life, as it says in John 10:10, what did John 10:10 say? It says, the thief came to, but I'm come that you might have, and have it how? But that cannot happen just because you quote the verse. That will not happen because you taught a big Bible. It will only happen when and as long as I keep working under me on the inside. But also remember that we have said it. What we said? We said, whatever you claim to have established within yourself, you'll be tested in it. That's why at the end of every term in school, it is assumed that all the teacher taught is inside of you. So what do they have? And most of you think holidays, not holidays, but tests. Before you go on the holidays, you get a
test.
Because the assumption is that you have learned. Very sadly, a lot of people realize they were in class, but they never learned. And the worst thing is to be where knowledge was being dispensed, and I didn't learn.
Good. I'm sure you've been, blown away by the depth of revelation the Lord is giving us in this season. That's just the tip of the iceberg. If you get the DVDs, if you get the CDs, if you get the manual, I'm telling you, you'll be better set. In fact, we challenge people who come to such workshops or to the service like that to get up and go teach it yourself. You read the manual, look for scriptures, and teach it to some class that you have. Teach it on the job at lunchtime or wherever. Amen? Because what the Lord has given us is for the body of Christ, for the kingdom of God. Okay, this is August. You would have heard, and if you haven't heard yet, because you are now being introduced to Divine Destiny Worship Center, the month of August is a very August month for us. I say nothing about my birthday, but what I really gonna be talking about is that on Friday nights, we are not having any services in the sanctuary. But what we do is that we challenge all families to turn the Friday night that they would have been coming to Friday service into Friday or family Friday night. Go out or throw up a barbecue at the back of your yard or do it in the front, whichever way you want. Just gather, call people over and have a nice time of fellowship. Amen? So for every Friday night of the month of August, we will not be gathering at church. What we'll be doing is gathering as families to fellowship. Oh, I like that. Family fellowship Friday night. Good. If you show up here in Diego Martin, you will not see anybody because we will be following our own instructions. Amen? Good. But of course, we have services on the Sundays. We have Sunday service. And we also have our radio programs. Monday, every Monday night at 9 p.m., we are on 98.1 with It's Your Date with Destiny, the radio version. On a Tuesday at 107.1 at 9:30 p.m., we are doing what? We are living the more abundant life. 9:30, 107.1. And on a Friday, of course, at 3 p.m., we have Ask Pastor Gemma, a question and answer program, which we caption as Apostle Gemma answering questions that few people dare to ask, and even fewer dare to answer. But she does. She is willing to answer whatever question you ask. Amen. And this is the month of August again. We're coming up to the month of September, and we want to stir up your pure minds now and get you all excited. Divine Destiny Credit Union, or we call it Destiny Credit Union, is opening up an opportunity for you to be counseled in financial matters, business matters. So on the 3rd, that's the first Saturday of September, we are going to be having a financial workshop. You look at the flyer there right now. The two conveners are Sister Catherine Bettel, and if you know about her, she and her husband, they are the ones that own and operate Bee's Ice Cream. So if you're talking about coaching concerning business, she is into the thing, and she's willing now to come and release what God has shown her over the years, what they have learned by trial and error in one session. On the third, look at the flyer, you see the time there. We want you to be part of it, and you realize you have to invest to get the harvest. So the cost is $200. We want you to grab hold of it. And of course, I am the other convener. I try my little thing here and there, and it's working. And because it's working, I want to share with you. You'll have opportunities to learn how to start business without having to get plenty money. We're going to teach you all of those things. And that's the third of September. On the 4th of September, we have our book bag blessing. You know, we can't send our students out back into the school system without laying hands on them, prophesying excellence to them. So at 5 p.m. on that Sunday, that's the 4th of September, we will have book bag blessing. Amen. So until we meet again, I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan, on behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters at Divine Destiny Worship Center, declaring to you, you began life as a winner. Don't live it as a victim or die as a loser. You're a God idea. Because when God made you, he had destiny on his mind. God bless you until we see you at Divine Destiny Worship Center this Sunday. Amen. God bless you. Next time on Divine Destiny Worship Center's program, this program, it's your date with destiny. You will hear.
And that's what's frustrating so many young men on the streets. All of them, most of them, went to junior sec. Or I should say were assigned. Many didn't go. That's why Trinidad should be one of the most literate countries. Why? Because education has been free for as long as, we could remember. Since Mahatma Gandhi was a little boy. In Trinidad, education was free. And maybe because, right, maybe because it's free. Because if mommy used to pay for it, she got beat you and send you to school. It's because it's free. When mommy knows she had to give up buying some new outfit just to pay your school fee. And you saying, you sick? You what? Well, boy, if you see how quick we used to get well in our house. All right, you staying home? Okay. Victor and Vernon didn't get to fill the barrel. So Vivian, you will, as long as you're home now, you will fill it. I want to revisit that. I feel good. Yeah, my belly hurts me again.
You continue to reach your goals through Jesus Christ. This has been It's Your Date with Destiny, a production of Divine Destiny Media Ministry. Until next time, you began life as a winner. Don't live life as a victim or die as a loser. For when God made you, he had destiny on his mind.